Welcome back to VideoProc Vlogger official channel. Today, I'm gonna share with you how to make the countdown timer effect that looks like what we put in the opening. If you're into this, just free download the VideoProc Vlogger from the comment section. Now, let's get started. In the first place, let's make the dynamic circle effect for the countdown timer. Launch up VideoProc Vlogger. Start a new project. Find the text icon on the toolbar, select it. Then go to the inspector panel to delete the text content. Now we can see from the preview window, the background turns into solid black, and there is a camera icon on the top. Click on it to get a black image. Next, let's get back to the main interface. Find out this icon, click on it. Changing the background color to white. Hit down to get back to the main interface. We can tell from the preview window that the background turns to white. In the same way, we click on a camera icon to get a white image. Then we add these two images to the program. Next, let's click on the icon again and change the background color to black. Now, let's drag the white image onto the video track. Add a black image onto the overlay track, changing their durations respectively. We want the black image to last longer. After making the changes, let's find the show layout rectangle icon under the preview window. Click on it. Adjust the size and the position of the black and the white images. After all of these edits, we get this. Our next step is getting to the upper left to find the effects. Open its panel, find the circular mask effect. Drag it onto the effects track. Adjust its duration to make it align with a black background. Then let's go to the inspector panel. Move this slider to adjust the gradient volume. Then go to the scope menu to determine the scope of the effect. Now we get this. But the shape of the circle doesn't look good enough. That's fine. We just need to click on the white background image on a video track and use the show layout rectangle feature to fine tune it. That can bring us an awesome result. Next, we need to use the shortcuts Ctrl and C to copy it, and use the Ctrl and V to paste it twice over here. Then we copy the black image on the overlay track, paste it over here. Adjust its duration. After that, let's go to the upper left and open the transition panel. Come over to the clock web. Take a preview. This matches the dynamic effect that we need. So let's drag it onto the video track for 3 times. Adjust their durations respectively. Now let's check out what we get. It looks good, isn't it? Now let's find a text icon on the toolbar. Click on it. Adjust its duration. Go to the inspector panel and edit the text content. Adjust the appearance and the size of the text. Scroll down to find the text shadow section. Let's decrease the offset volume to get rid of the shadow. After that, we need to reposition the number to the center. How do we locate the center? It's easy to do. Just click on the Show Rulers icon above the preview window. Hit the Add Crisscross Guide. Move the cursor to the middle of the canvas. VideoProc Vlogger will automatically snap the guides to the center position. By doing this, we can move the number to the center point directly. Let's click on this small eye to close the guide. Next, we copy the edited text clip. Paste it twice onto here. After the original text clip, changing the content of these two text clips by turn. That's all for adding the number. Now we've almost there. We just need to add a prepared background videos to the program. Find the plus icon on the far left of the overlay track. Click on it to add a new overlay track. Drag the background video onto this track. Resize the background video on the preview window to make it fill the entire screen. Now we can notice it's affected by the circular mask effect and appear as a round. To fix it, we need to click on the circular mask effect and make it not work for the background clip. Now we get the wanted result. Then let's adjust its duration. Find the blender mode section on the inspector panel. Select Screen Blender Mode. That's all for adding the background. To make the countdown timer effect look better, we can add a countdown sound effect. Drag the sound effect onto the audio track. Adjust the duration to make the sound effect and the video the same length. That's all. Let's take a look at our final work. Alright, that's all for today's tutorial. We'll bring you more tutorials about making some creative countdown timer effect. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Bye!